हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स सी हाउ टू ड्रॉ स्कीमैटिक हिस्टोलॉजी डायग्राम ऑफ यूसोफेगस। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ड्रॉइंग, लेट्स सी अबाउट दिस ट्यूबुलर स्ट्रक्चर यूसोफेगस। व्हेन वी टेक अ क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ यूसोफेगस, यू विल सी द ल्यूमेन ऑफ द यूसोफेगस। फ्रॉम ल्यूमिनल साइड आउटवर्ड हिस्टोलॉजिकली यूसोफेगस शोज फोर लेयर। दिज आर, यू कैन सी, म्यूकोजा, सब म्यूकोजा, मस्कुलरिस एक्सटर्ना एंड एडवेंटिशिया और सीरोजा। यू कैन रिमेंबर दिज आर द लेयर्स, दैट इज एम एस एम एस, फ्रॉम इनसाइड आउट, दैट इज फ्रॉम ल्यूमिनल साइड आउटवर्ड। नाउ म्यूकोजा विच इज इनर मोस्ट लेयर फेसिंग दिस ल्यूमिनल साइड, हियर इट हैज नॉन केराटिनाइज स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वैमस एपिथेलियम। दिस एपिथेलियम रेस्ट ऑन द लैमिना प्रोप्रिया विच इज लूज कनेक्टिव टिश्यू। And then there is a muscle layer of the mucosa itself, that is the muscularis mucosa. The next layer which we have to draw, that is the submucosa. In esophagus, we have to draw the submucosal glands. The next layer to this submucosa, it is the muscularis externa. Now, as you can see, this length of the esophagus is 25 centimeter. The upper one third, which is near oral cavity, it shows the skeletal muscle or striated muscle in muscularis externa. While the middle one third, it shows mixed, that is skeletal and smooth muscle. While the lower one third, they shows the smooth muscle in the muscularis externa. It has again inner circular and outer longitudinal layer. Between these two muscle layers of muscularis externa, there is myenteric plexus of nerves, also known as Orbach's plexus, which is important for peristaltic movement of the esophagus. The last layer of the esophagus is the adventitia, which is just a loose connective tissue with blood vessels and nerves. Now, as the lower 1 inch of the esophagus, it shows peritoneal covering. We can say the serosa is present in the lower part of the esophagus. So these are the four layers which we have to draw in today's diagram. So let's start drawing HNA diagram. Very first, drawing this basal lamina or basement membrane over which this stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium. This is a multi-layer epithelium. Middle layer cells, they are polygonal. Cells of this esophagus, epithelium of the esophagus, they take dark stain and somewhat basophilic. This is because of the tonofilaments which are present in them. The uppermost layer here, you can see this is squamous or flattened. So this is the multi-layered, that is stratified epithelium. As this is schematic diagram, we are showing the cell walls clearly and the nuclei. Only cells resting on the basement membrane or basal lamina, they undergo mitosis. The new cell layer thus formed, it moves superficially. These are the connective tissue papillae of the lamina propria. This lamina propria, it is also shows some of the lymphoid aggregates. Below lamina propria, you can see the smooth muscle layer of the muscularis mucosa. Next to it, there is the submucosa is there. We have to take a longer box for drawing this histology of esophagus. So this complete three part, that is, this is epithelium, uppermost layer cells of this epithelium, they are squamous, and this is multi-layer epithelium, so it's a protective epithelium. This non-keratinous stratified squamous epithelium is found only at two sites of the gastrointestinal tract. One is the esophagus and other is the anal canal. Just below it, here you can see the connective tissue, which is showing the blood vessels. This is lamina propria. It is a loose connective tissue which supports this epithelium. The next part of this mucosa, this is the muscularis mucosa, which is muscle layer of the mucosa itself. So these three things, that is epithelium, lamina propria and muscularis mucosa, they together form the mucosa here. Next layer of the esophagus, that is the submucosa. Submucosa, it shows the connective tissue, then elastic fibers, and inside these submucosa you will find submucosal glands. So I am drawing these submucosal mucus secreting glands are there, and these glands, they are compound tubulo alveolar glands. Other than esophagus, in gastrointestinal tract, such submucosal glands are seen in duodenum, where the submucosal glands secrete the bicarbonate, while in esophagus, the submucosal glands, it secretes mucus secretion. As these are the mucus gland, we have to draw the flat nucleus, which is toward the basal lamina. Duct of the submucosal gland, it enters the muscularis mucosa, then lamina propria, and then open inside the lumen of esophagus. So this is one of the duct you can see. This is submucosa, it shows larger blood vessel nerves. So these are the blood vessels. Then connective tissue and elastic fibers, they are also present in ample amount in submucosa. The elastic fibers in the submucosa, they are important as this allows distension of esophagus during passage of the food from the lumen of esophagus. Connective tissue and connective fibers, like elastic fibers and connective tissue fibers, they are seen better with Mason trichome strain. This part is a submucosa. With here submucosal glands. Just have a look. Why these glands are looking in section like this, multiple rounded structure? This is because now these esophageal submucosal gland, they are compound tubulo alveolar gland. So you can see this tubular structure of this gland, and these are somewhat alveolar or rounded spherical structures of this gland. When the section is taken from the submucosa, you can see the rounded acini, they are appearing. And here you can see this is a mucus secreting gland. So the pyramidal shaped cells are there, and the nucleus is flattened and it is pushed to the basal part of the cell. The apical part of this mucus secreting cell, it is having a foamy cytoplasm and it stains faintly. This is because the mucus in the cytoplasm of this mucus gland, It is washed away during the slide preparation. The lumen of the mucus secreting gland, it is wider as compared to the serous glands, and the mucus glands, they stain somewhat pale or lighter as compared to the serous acini. Cross section of this mucus secreting gland, you can also see the myoepithelial cells, which are also known as basket cell, which surround these mucus acini, and the contraction of these myoepithelial cells, it helps in squeezing out these secretions of these glands. Thus, this is a branched, you can see branches of this tubulo alveolar gland. So it is a compound tubulo alveolar gland which is present in the submucosa of the esophagus, and is important for lubricating the food which is present in the lumen of esophagus and thus facilitating its movement. Now the next layer is the muscularis externa. So here it is having inner circular layer and outer longitudinal layer. The circular fibers, as they are running like this, you have to draw. So these are the inner circular layer, longitudinal layer. In cross section it appears somewhat like this because fibers are running along the length of the esophagus. Between these two layers, that is inner circular and outer longitudinal layer, the myenteric, that is between the muscles, so myenteric plexus of nerves is situated, which is also known as Auerbach plexus of nerves. And this plexus of nerve is important for peristalsis movement of the esophagus. So labeling on this side, muscularis externa, also known as muscularis propria. This is inner circular layer and this is outer. The last layer of the esophagus is adventitia or serosa, where it is a connective tissue layer which shows blood vessels, nerves. So these are the few blood vessels. So this is the schematic diagram of histology of esophagus.